press 1 to accept this.
This call may be monitored or recorded.
Hey, Randy.
Hey, Bill.
You wanted to make a statement, you said?
Yeah. I know that a lot of people may listen to this that were on radio shows that we were on originally with Heather and Lisa and Brian and Bob and you. And I was on quite a few of those shows where I would come on and read from a book that I had learned a lot from, and that book is called Love Without End, Jesus Speaks. One of the things that comes to mind for me is the Hadron Collider or the Super Collider, where they're looking for the God particle, as they call it. Well, Jesus explained in the book that this particle will be found only when you look at it from the heart instead of with the mind. And as you and I were talking earlier about quantumness, I believe we're in a period of time where the quantumness is really showing itself, especially to those of us who can see it. You know, things are coming to me that way now where they're just, I know that's what's happening. It's hard to explain, but it's like I understand it, but I don't know how to explain it type of situation.
Yeah, you don't have the words.
Exactly. But I know that's what's happening because I can see it happen. And, you know, like I was telling you earlier, sometimes, especially in the situation I'm in here in jail, in confinement, we're not allowed a lot. And it's amazing how a book can just, all of a sudden somebody hand me a book, here, you might like to read this. And it'll, like, be something that I'm really interested in, you know, and the information in it might be fictional to a point, but there's going to be something in there that I needed to hear or read that kind of locks things together for me. But anyway, I was talking with Patricia earlier today, and we've been discussing some things about this case, and one of the things that I wanted to clarify with people who are listening is I keep getting thrown under the category of a sovereign, and I've never labeled myself as anything other than a living man who comes in peace. And I want to reiterate that and what that means for me, because the first time that I was pulled over and 13 cops surrounded my vehicle trying to get me to tell them I was a sovereign being, the day before I had come across some information that explained to me that a sovereign was now considered a terrorist of the United States. So I knew to answer that question a different way than what they wanted me to answer it, so I never gave them their answer they kept looking for. And that really upset these men to the point of abusing me and arresting me and putting falsified warrants against me. I don't know why they continued to try to get me to admit being a sovereign, but their implication that is that I have done that. There is only one instance where I signed a piece of paper saying that I was a sovereign, but I signed it under duress. And if that signature is ever brought out, anyone who knows signing something under duress will understand that that signature means nothing because it was signed under duress. So if that's what they're going on, they have nothing to go on. And I just wanted to put it out there that the sovereign movement, the way the government describes it, is a terrorist organization. We are not terrorists, and as I would understand, anybody who is associated with me would understand, I simply come as a living man in peace, and I will always come as a living man in peace. And I just wanted to get that bit of information out so that people can understand the perspective of where we come from is truth.
That's beautiful.
And, go ahead.
That's beautiful.
It's frustrating being labeled something you've never considered yourself labeled as, or I've never labeled myself per se as anything other than a living man. And I don't think that's anything to be illegal.
No. Well,
it's very lawful.
You know, there was a guy 2,000 years ago that called himself the Son of Man too, so.
Exactly. Exactly.
That has a long precedent.
Yes, and he came to show us how to live our lives and to have it more abundantly. And that's what we're all about, is showing others the away.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that we're being forced to be looked at as the opposite. But it's coming back in their face really hard.
Right, right. Right. And it's good you put that out there, because I've never felt comfortable with that label, and I've never been associated with those movements anyway.
Right, exactly.
There is a crossover as far as some of the data they have, and I'm not
right.
I'm not dishing anyone that who has come from that.
No.
You know,
no judgment.
That's their you know, particular doing. But
I had an officer tell me himself. He said, "Well, we're all sovereign. It's just being labeled as a sovereign." Sovereign citizen that they consider to be illegal in their terms.
Yeah.
But being a sovereign is not, there's nothing wrong with being sovereign. Sovereign simply means I don't need anyone other than God to get my direction from, or source, creator.
Well,
that's where I get my...
That's what a living man does, you know?
Exactly. The labels aren't important to me. Just being who you are and doing, that's what Heather says, but go and be and do. And the first time I heard her say that, it's like I told Lisa on the phone the other night, first time I heard Heather say that, something is almost like sticking a key into a cylinder and all the, everything lines up and you turn it and it goes ka-chunk. Something happened when she said that, and I knew, beyond a shadow of a doubt, Heather and I would be doing something together, and I never in a million years dreamed it would be anything like this, but when it came together, it just came together perfectly.
Yeah, it's quite the doing you two are doing, and we think she's on her way there now, so.
Awesome. I look forward to feeling her. I hope they bring her where I'm at, so, because I got a feeling that's going to be powerful.
Yeah. So,
but I really want to put out my gratitude to everyone who has sent cards and letters that have been returned, and I hate that, you know, I know some of those letters have been put in my personal property that didn't get returned, but the ones that did, I really apologize that we didn't have the correct information from the get-go and that they didn't get those letters to us, but you know, it's part of the process of them delaying anything for us that would help out in any way, shape, or form. They're really pushing hard to make it difficult for us to achieve this. The harder they work, the easier it makes it for us.
Yeah, they're showing their motives and all this.
Yes, exactly. But I really appreciate everybody out there who's supporting us. I'm hearing a lot of good information and wishing that I could read things on my own and hear things and videos and things, but I'm, you know, all I can hear is what you guys send me, and what I hear on these phone calls is the only information I get. And I just want to put out a heartfelt thanks for all that.
Yeah, and there's thousands and thousands of people out there watching this.
Yeah, it's awesome the people are coming together who stand in the truth.
And I want to add that if anybody wants to send money to Randy's defense, the PayPal address is rkbfund@gmail.com. So it's rkbfund@gmail.com is the PayPal address. Patricia's handling all that.
And please keep those cards coming. They usually, when I wake up in the morning, there'll be mail under my door if there's any. And it really helps to make my day go by. Just a simple little card. Just a simple postcard that's plain white postcard. No pictures or anything, but just those words of encouragement really help.
Do they have to have a return address?
It does not have to if you just want to put your name on it. Well, you know, if you've seen just a white postcard, it doesn't matter because they're going to let me have it. What they're returning is letters in sealed envelopes and postcards with pictures on the front. They're returning all those if they have an address on them to be returned to. Otherwise, they're sticking it in my personal property.
So anything with a picture, they return?
Yes.
Huh.
Yep, they return postcards with pictures on them. Like I said, like I told Patricia, if you want me to have it, if it's something you want me to have, send it to me without a return address, but put your name on it. And, you know, that way they'll put it in my personal property. That's all. That's one way of doing it.
Okay. But you won't see those till later.
Hey, I won't get those till I get out of this place.
Okay, so everybody send them white postcards.
Yes. And they say you can pick those up at the post office for like 40 cents.
Okay.
But they're much appreciated.
Yeah, it's,
I've gotten some really great postcards from all over the United States of people who are listening and supporting and looking forward to all this coming to a close. But the more people that come together and hold the energy for this to happen, it's going to happen soon.
Yeah, and it's we're seeing it from all over the globe right now too.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I can feel it. People don't understand how sometimes I can wake up in the middle of the night and just feel the energy.
Mm-hmm.
It's, and I just have to lay there and grin because I know it's powerful.
Mm-hmm. It's very powerful.
Yeah. So I just wanted to get that clear on the Sovereign, and thank you for allowing me to share that.
No problem. I'll get this out there as soon as we get done here.
All right.
How you doing on time as far as talking?
I'm good until we hear that 60 second.
Morning.
The lady come out and say 60 seconds. So if there's something else you want to ask me, feel free to.
No, you might want to tell them what block you're in and what beings are in that block.
The one thing that they need, I don't know if you have the address or where I'm at. The one thing they need is my identification number, which is 318-366.
Mm-hmm.
And then my name, Randall Bean, B-E-A-N-E, R-A-N-D-A-L-L.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm not sure the address, if you could maybe post that along with this video somewhere.
I'll post it. It's the Blount County Jail, correct?
Yes, Blount County. It's called Blount County, but it's spelled B-O-B-L-O-U-N-T.
Right. And people can Google that as well. So.
Yeah.
And you're kind of, they put you kind of in a maximum security part of it, didn't they?
Yes, yes. For some reason, they feel like I'm need to be under maximum security, but... From my understanding, Heather says a lot's going on with me for protection, which makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're really coming down. If a lot of people know what's going on in my life, they really come down hard on me every way they can, any way they can. In ways I never dreamed they would.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of what they're saying about me is pure lies. And like I said, that's fine. But because they're showing their true colors through everything.
Mm-hmm.
And they can't stop it.
It's one of these turning points in history.
Yes, yes.
I don't know how the drama unfolds. I just know it does.
Right.
And
yep.
And it comes to a beautiful ending.
Yeah. Heather and I had a beautiful conversation on July 4th of this year. I called her and I said, Heather, happy Independence.
You have 60 seconds.
Or saying Independence Day, that for some reason I've never thought about it like that, but turning inward for our dependence instead of looking outward for something.
Yes.
Made a big difference for me this year on that day. And of course that was the day Heather and I shared that it was 0 point.
Mm-hmm.
And there's something really beautiful about that.
And that's the good, that goes back to connecting to your heart, like we were talking about earlier.
Exactly, and that's exactly where we were that day in our heart space, because we both went through a situation and we just felt like it was divine timing on us coming together and doing what we had to do.
Mm-hmm. It's not an easy task you two have.
Do what now?
It's not an easy task you guys have.
No, it's not. But we were ready for it.
Sure. Make it all seem.
Your time has expired. This call may have been monitored or recorded.